Welcome, Bearcat fans. It's boys lacrosse senior night here on the campus of Kentucky Country Day. We are about 15 minutes out from game time with a fantastic matchup between two Kentucky State Lacrosse League powers as your KCD boys lacrosse team takes on the South Oldham Dragons. Hello, everybody. This is Zachary Lee, the voice of your KCD Bearcats on this beautiful day. We are in for a great game, and thank you for tuning in. Sponsored by Live Sportscaster, we bring you the pregame face-off between the Bearcats and Dragons. Again, in his second year, the KCD Bearcats head coach is Ryan Smith, joined by third-year offensive coordinator Andrew Wolford and first-year goalies coach Justin Burks. KCD comes into tonight's game with a 3-6 record after their most difficult loss of the season, down 5 goals to North Oldham, coming all the way back to a 1-goal lead. But after the Mustangs tied the game late in the last minute, North held the ball for the last-minute possession that they used with the entire minute to score a goal as the buzzer sounded. KCD was defeated on that night with a score of 9-8. Senior attack number 4, Zach Vine, led the scoring that night with, again, 4 goals. The season hasn't gone as planned for sure for the Bearcats, but sitting in second in the district behind Christian Academy, the Bearcats still have a long road in front of them and can easily turn things around tonight against a quality opponent, South Oldham. For the Bearcats, the player to watch tonight going to have to be midfielder Asa Hyken. The key to the game tonight for him would have to be definitely being facilitating on offense. It's part of his role on this team. And against the number 3 team in the state by some people's standards, he will definitely have to work hard to help the Bearcats out tonight. South Oldham comes in with a 9-3 record after defeating Bryan Station out of Lexington 12-15. Last season, the Bearcats defeated the Dragons 15-10 in a high-scoring game. Head coach Joe Ritchie and his experienced squad will look to take down the Bearcats on what will be a fantastic game tonight. Before we get to a break, prior to tonight's starting lineup, we would like to thank the KCD Booster Club for funding the equipment that's producing tonight's game, as well as Cameron Rennert on camera and Ramarthan Rangaswamy on highlights. Thanks to them for getting the job done behind the scenes. We will take a short break and see both team starters introduced here in a few minutes, and along with the national anthem, here, right here on the GOKCD network.
South Oldham High School. At attack, number one, Grant Prince. At attack, number three, Luke Niebrugge. At attack, number 10, Nathan Ledford. In the midfield, long stick midi, number two, Noah Ensert. Number six, Ian Gifford. And number 18, Trevor Chapman. On defense, number 37, Austin Kern. And in goal, number 21, Jack Kordek. Starting lineups for the Bearcats of KCD. At attack, number 2, Patrick Dermody. At attack, number 4, Zach Vine. At attack, number 8, Justin Grissom. In the midfield, at long stick midi, number 6, Ashton Robinson. Number 27, Colin Ferguson. On defense, number 23, Zach Ellis. Defense number 24, Blake Robbins. Defense number 37, Connor Collis. In the midfield, as well as on defense, number 3, Nick Tevenbaugh. And in goal, number 34, Ben Gould.
All right, welcome back, Bearcat fans. We're going to get started here in a minute. We'd like to thank Live Sportscaster for sponsoring today's opening face-off between the Dragons and the Bearcats. Your starters are lining up here now, and again, this should be a great game tonight. KCD coming off a tough loss again against South, I guess, rival you could call them, the North Oldham Mustangs. Great story from that game. The game winner came from a kid whose mother apparently was very sick at the time and was able to score that goal with no time remaining. And felt like it was a good story for them. Obviously, the Bearcats came up short, but always take some kind of positive out from that type of game. So, again, the Bearcats have played a tough schedule this year. Played a couple teams out of Lexington and already playing the state champion of last year, St. X, in the first game of the year. And looking to just keep fighting tonight and definitely have a great game, hopefully, on our hands here. Out of tonight's game and on the sideline over there is Jackson Alford, senior leader and defender for the Bearcats. Other than that, I don't think that there's too many guys missing here tonight. Looks like the Bearcats will also be possibly, I can't tell, I think that the Bearcats will also be without Dexter Walters tonight, but we shall see here. Your senior night ceremony will be at halftime, and we look forward to bringing that here. Head football coach Matthew Jones announcing tonight's game over the PA, and he'll have your senior night ceremony as well. Bit of a delay to start here, but we should get underway here soon. We again thank you for tuning in. If you want to give us a shout out, mention us on Twitter at KCD Athletics, and we'll be sure to give you a shout out on the network here, today's game. And you can follow the KCD Boys Lacrosse team on Twitter at KCD Boys Lacs. And then on Facebook as well, there's usually some game photos on there and constant score updates of every game from Twitter. So lots of ways to follow your Bearcats. And it looks like we are going to get underway here. Facing off for the Bearcats, looks like it'll be Patrick Dermody. We are just about getting ready to be underway here. And let's see here. Nick Teva ball comes away with it. Passes over to Dermody. And he's going to look for his pass inside to Ferguson, and he scores! Goal, senior Colin Ferguson. Assist from Justin Grissom.
KCD goal, number 27, Colin Ferguson, on a beautiful assist from Justin Grissom.
That was a great play there for the Bearcats. Way to get on the board here early with 11:40 left in the first quarter. Your score, KCD 1. South Oldham 0. So a great start for the Bearcats here. Hopefully they can keep this trend going here. They set up a great play, and Ferguson was wide open in front of the goal, and he was able to convert. Facing off again for the Bearcats, Patrick Dermody. There's the whistle. And Dermody comes away with it. Stumbles a little bit, gets back up, makes a pass. Vine, he scores! Wow, you cannot ask for a better start for the Bearcats, especially coming off such a tough loss like they had last week. This is a great, great start Two seniors scoring early here. Zach Vine there with the assist from Patrick Dermody. So, again, great start for the Bearcats, and they're up 2-0 with 11:32 left in the first quarter. Again, facing off for the Bearcats, Dermody. Face off, there's the whistle. He bullies through, there's a whistle. That'll go for the Bearcats. It'll be Bearcat ball. And Dermody picks it up. There's the whistle. He passes over to Jared Frank. And there's our key to the game tonight, our player to watch, Asa Hyken. Passes over to Ferguson. Passes to Grissom. Back to Dermody. To Vine. Bearcats looking for some space here. Back to Hyken. I'm guessing that the Bearcats will again try to set something up inside here. We'll see. Frank back to Hyken. Hyken look for some space. Oh. Yep, that's going to go back to the Dragons. After an errant pass went just out of the reach of, I believe, Dermody over there. And number 18 for the Dragons takes it out. Number 6 on the run here. Ferguson defending. This will be obviously a key area. Oh, that's not a good pass there. And that will be Bearcat ball. Bearcats, you can't ask for a better, again, you can't ask for a better start. Up 2-0 here with about 10 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Oh, ball down. And oh no, the Dragons have got some space here. Back to number 3, he takes a shot. Yep, and they score. That was a bad turnover. There was not enough people back for the Bearcats, and they South Oldham was able to convert on that play. Number 3, Luke Niebergi on the goal for the Dragons. Makes it 2-1 with 9:57 left in this first quarter. Bearcats still up one, but, and honestly, that was probably just a bad giveaway there. I wouldn't say it was a fluke goal, but it was just a bad giveaway from the Bearcats. They were just 2-on-1, and they were able to put it away. I'll tell you what, Dermody's really fighting on that face-off tonight, and that's a change. I don't think we've usually had him in the face-off spot down there, but maybe down a few guys. That's the situation for tonight. And I can't. That was a quick restart. Somehow ended up being a turnover for the Bearcats. But regardless, the Dragons will have it on offense here. With 9:30 left in the first quarter, it's KCD 2, South Oldham 1. And what many would consider at least a top 10, top 15 matchup in the state. Oh, he slips. Number 18 slips on that play. Oh, that was a way to get back up. Oh, that was a beautiful goal for South Oldham. Number 18, Trevor Chapman slipped on that play. I think he may have even lost the ball, was able to get back up and take a shot that got a great bounce, and that was just an all-around great play for the Dragons there, and they're able to tie it up here with 9:13 left in this first quarter here. Back at the faceoff here. Dermody almost wins it. Let's see who picks it up. Yep, it'll be South Oldham ball. They picked it up. Tiva ball fighting hard there, and Ashton Robinson able to get the ball away from him, and he's able to recover off the, oh, but a bad pass will be result in a turnover for the Bearcats, and South Oldham will set their offense up here. Again, it was a great start for the Bearcats, getting up 2-0 very early in this first quarter, but South Oldham has rebounded well, and they're showing a lot of people here tonight why they're probably – at least in that top five team list here. So, oh, and he slips again. There's a call. I believe that was in the crease. Yep, in the crease. So that'll be Bearcat ball. And Ashton Robinson passes back to Ben Gould, who will hold it. He is out of the goal, but he passes over to Ferguson, who's going to get away from the defense there. He's still going. He's got to find somebody here. He's able to get out of the trouble and make a pass. That probably wasn't the best idea to go back inside with that. He had a few guys out wide. Oh, that was a great hit there. And Frank recovers the ball. They're kind of slowing down, but okay, there's no call there, but thought possibly with the hit that there could possibly be a penalty on the play, but no penalty. Vine takes it out from top. He'll look for some space. Makes a move inside. Still has the ball. Takes a shot. Oh, yes, that went in. Score, Bearcats. Zach Vine with his second of the game, and that was a great effort. He took on about 3 to 4 defenders, made a move inside, and took a very high shot, went down low to the right of the goalie, and put it away. And that'll be a timeout for the Dragons. South Oldham, Bearcats up 3-2 with 7:35 left in the first quarter. We'll take a quick break and be right back on the GOKCD Network. Thank you for tuning in. All right, welcome back, Bearcat fans. Quick timeout there for the Dragons to kind of regroup. And Dermody will be back there for the faceoff after a goal by the Bearcats by Zach Vine. Again, his second of the game. Again, it's a beautiful day here in Louisville, Kentucky, in the 70s here today. This is the kind of weather you want for a senior night. Dermody tries to get out of the trouble here. Again, South Oldham so far showing that they're a fairly well-balanced team, but this looks to be a high-scoring game. It usually is between the Bearcats and Dragons every year, it seems like. I believe 2 years ago, there was an overtime game as well between the Bearcats and Dragons. And they also met in the playoffs 2 years ago. So, oh, that was a kind of a high stick there, but Ferguson still getting hit up high. Oh, almost put it away there. But looks like it'll be, it'll remain Bearcat ball. Zach Vine out there. Looking around, trying to find somebody. Grissom back inside. Oh, goodness, that was close. Dermody trying to fight for the ball, and he comes away with it. He's got a little bit of space. Oh, that was a great goal for the Bearcats. Dermody, the great shot inside and scores. Again, Patrick Dermody. That's his favorite shot, and when he finds a little bit of space like that, you would want to believe that he would take it, and he did. Puts the Bearcats up by 2 goals here with 6:28 left in the first quarter. It is KCD 4, South Oldham 2. And Dermody will come back to face off again for the Bearcats. He wins the face off. Can't keep the ball, though. He kind of tossed it away there. I think he was just trying to get it out of trouble. South Oldham player kind of flings it up there, and Connor Collis, a senior, recovers it. He's got to get that ball out. Timeout, KCD. So with 6:11 left in the first quarter, it is KCD 4, South Oldham 2. We will take another quick break here and be right back on the GOKCD Network. All right, welcome back, Bearcat fans. Jared Frank, I'm actually able to pick it up there. He kind of tipped it back in. Oh, goodness, that was a close shot there. Zach Vine, the Bearcats have found a lot of space inside today. I think it's partially been the plays that have been called have set them up for great opportunities inside as well. Bearcats trying to tip it away there and still aren't able to pick it up. That looks like Robbins over there. And I goodness. Number 10 for the Dragons, able to score there. That ball just kind of rolled around. He was able to pick it up, and Nathan Ledford able to pick that ball up. And then the whole kind of left side of the goal had a ton of space in it because the area was occupied by Bearcats trying to recover the ball. So the Dragons able to get a goal there off another defensive miscue from the Bearcats. So with 5:30 left in this first quarter, your score, KCD 4, South Oldham 3. Again, it's been a great game to watch so far for sure, and we thank you for tuning in. Dermody on the faceoff. That'll go the way of the Bearcats, and there's another whistle. I guess I can tell them get back to the spot and get on the restart there. All right, there's the whistle back for the play. Grissom over to Vine. Passes back to, there's Dexter Walters. I didn't know if he was here or not today, but out there for the Bearcats, another one of the seniors. I think we might, besides Jackson Alford out there, every senior is actually on the field right now. So Dexter looks for some space. Three guys defending there for South Oldham. But again, this is opening things up inside. Oh, Vine looks for some space. What a goal from Zach Vine. Giving him a hat trick already in this first quarter. So far, you can really tell that Vine and Dermody have been led the way for the Bearcats today so far, and they're really, Really putting a good team effort in here today. Honestly, two of the three goals from South Oldham have come from pretty big defensive miscues that I would say have been fairly, would be fairly easily correctable. But regardless, puts the Bearcats up by two with 4:46 left in this first quarter. KCD 5, South Oldham 3. And Tiva ball really getting pestered out there, but Zach Vine somehow comes away with the ball there. Back to Dermody. Tiva ball will come off. And that's Grissom running out there, looking for some space. Potentially somebody get a shot off. Back to Walters. And Bearcats still looking for something, probably setting a play up here, and there's a ball down. Dermody's trying to fight for it, but South Oldham will come away with the ball. There's a long pass that is bouncing, and Gould able to recover it and passes it long to Walters, who gets it, and he's got a little bit of space here. There's a guy wide open in front of the goal. He doesn't take that, but he takes it to Vine. I'm not sure if he didn't see Grissom there or what happened on the play, but we're going to have a shot here for sure. Oh, goodness. South Oldham able to recover pretty quickly on that play, and oh, goodness, that was a big hit out at wide there from Dermody. Ball's down. There's a shot. Again, it's an area of chaos right now, and there's a call going against the Bearcats, so that'll be a turnover. And it was a decent possession until Dermody kind of took a hit out there and lost the ball, and then chaos kind of ensued from there. But Dragons with possession here in the first quarter with about 2 minutes and 45 seconds left. It's KCD 5 and South Oldham 3. Again, South Oldham 9-3 on the year. Not too many bad losses for sure, and have kind of controlled their way. Oh, Jared Frank. Oh, goodness. There is a penalty flag on the play there. I'm not all too sure what that was for, but there is a flag on the play, so. That'll put Frank out. And we'll give South Oldham a bit of an advantage here for a little bit. And there's your whistle back for play. Oh! Hard shot there from number 18 for the Dragons. Number 3 trying to find some space. He passes it back out at wide. Tiva ball trying to defend on the play. Ashton Robinson defending. Oh, goodness. Did that go in? I can't tell. He saved that there. Ben Gould.
Great save by Gould.
And that pass, that ball is rolling around out there. Vine, let's see if he can get to it. Ah, he can't. It goes just out of bounds. Let's see what the call is. Yep, it'll be South Oldham ball. There's a whistle back for play. He passes back to their goalie. With 1 minute left to go in this first quarter, it's KCD 5, South Oldham 3. There's a bad pass that he's able to recover. South Oldham definitely not out of this game, and Still early. Seems like the Dragons have kind of had trouble with their footing on this field. I'm almost positive they play on turf as well, so I wouldn't say that's playing a disadvantage for them, but kind of been a footing issue for them. But number 18 with a shot that goes over the bar, and let's see. Yep, the Dragons will maintain possession. Number 3 makes a move inside, can't find any space, reverses, and number 6 with a shot, and that goes just to the right of the goal. But they will maintain possession with 22.1 seconds left to go in the first quarter. So the Dragons have a little bit of time here. We'll see what they can pull together. There's the whistle. Clock rolling here. Number 3 is going to look for some space, and there's a shot. Couldn't really see where it went over, but it went out to the left side, and let's see. Yep, South Oldham will retain possession. 10 seconds left to go here. He's going to rip a shot, and Gould with a save. So that will probably effectively end your – yep, that'll end the first quarter. So at the end of one here at Kentucky Country Day, your score, KCD Bearcats 5, South Oldham Dragons 3. We will be right back with the second quarter of action right here on the GOKCD Network. All right, we are back here with the second quarter of action. And we have switched sides. South Oldham starting out possession in the second quarter. We want to thank you all for tuning in tonight. South Oldham looking to get back in this game, down by 2 goals. Oh, he had a little bit of space here. He reverses. Oh, that deflected off the back of Ben Gould, and the Dragons are able to score there.
South Oldham goal number 6, Ian Gifford.
Ian Gifford able to find some space. Went off Ben Gould's back. Jared Frank worked hard on the play there, but not able to kind of get that ball away from him. That'll be a goal for South Oldham. And Dermody will face off. Dermody trying to scoop that ball up, but he can't. It'll be South Oldham ball. Teva ball trying to defend. Number 18 is able to get past him. He's held the ball all the way. Teva ball just can't seem to get him free of that ball there. There's Zach Ellis defending out there, another one of our football players. Plays on the offensive line for the KCD football team. Like Robbins defending. That's a quick burst from number three there from South Oldham. He's going to look for some space. Ashton Robinson trying to defend. Oh, a big hit inside from Connor Collis. He kind of flew up in the air regardless, and I guess you could call it a hit. That's when his brother was still playing last year, they called that hit fiesta and tried to get me to trend that on Twitter for him, unsuccessfully, if I might add. But obviously they're just having fun with that. But part of the nature of lacrosse, sometimes you get a big hit in there every once in a while. You're obviously hoping to not get a penalty every time, but they have fun with it. See, there's a whistle. That's going the other way. I didn't see the call there. But it'll be South Oldham ball with 9:53 left in the second quarter. It's KCD 5, South Oldham 4. And Vine will try to got a hit there, but wasn't able to do anything for Bearcats. But Robbins trying to get that ball away out there. Again, it's incredible to think about the athletes that are on the field right now and consider the fact that a lot of these guys are multi-sport athletes, and almost all of them are all successful or starters in most of those other sports. So, again, the nature of a small school like KCD here, you're able to play multiple sports and you're able to be fairly successful in all those sports if you want to. So there's a save by Gould there, and there is a flag down. I think that's going to go against the Bearcats. Actually, no. Let's see. For 30-second penalty there against the Bearcats on Patrick Dermody. So Bearcats will be a man down here, give the Dragons an opportunity to possibly tie this game up here with about 9 minutes. Let's go. There was a big shot out by number three for South Oldham. Oh, goodness. There's a great goal from South Oldham. Number six for the Dragons.
South Oldham goal by number six, Ian Gifford, his second.
Ian Gifford's second of the game. Honestly, the Bearcats have done a good job staying inside, but and the edges of their defense have let a few goals go here today. And with 8:40 left in your second quarter here at Kentucky Country Day, it's KCD 5, South Oldham 5. We're all tied up here, and South Oldham's fought hard to get back in this game a couple times. So Bearcats will need to look to get something going here. It all starts with that face-off. And Dermody wins it. He's getting pestered by a couple of South Oldham defenders. He's able to get the ball away, but not able to get it back to one of his teammates. And it'll be South Oldham ball. Go, And it is senior night here at KCD, so we hope you'll stay tuned in at halftime as our senior night ceremony occurs here. We have six seniors. Asa Hyken, Jackson Alford, Connor Collis, Colin Ferguson, and Dexter Walters. So tuned in for that. Push, and that'll be Bearcat ball. Yep. Zach Ellis almost gave that away to a South Oldham player there. I don't think he saw him coming. It was a good play by the – oh, Hyken able to kind of make a few men miss there. It was a good move to get out of the trouble. And our player to watch tonight will set up the offense. There's Vaughn looking for some space. He passes inside to Grissom, who puts it away and scores for the Bearcats. Great assist by Vine there, and he found a wide open Grissom to score.
KCD goal by number eight, Justin Grissom, on a beautiful assist from Zach Vine.
So Vine already here with a great game. He has two assists and three goals on the night. Grissom has found space a couple of times right dead in front of that goal. And the opposites of defense here have been evident so far, where we see the Bearcats have been strong inside and not on the edges, but just the opposite for the Dragons. So Dermody fighting hard for that faceoff down there, but Dragons will come away with it. Number 22 off for the Dragons. With 6:45 left in the second quarter, it's KCD 6, South Oldham 5. Again, it's pretty impressive to see the Bearcats rebound like this against such a great team. And after a heartbreaking loss against North Oldham, it's just good to see how this team has been able to rebound so far. So, oh, there's a pass inside that goes, and he's number one, I believe, for the Dragons. Was open inside, but good defense by the Bearcats. Pushes his shot over top. Oh, there's a shot inside, and that was an easy goal. He kind of pushed right forward into the defense of the Bearcats. And
South Oldham goal by number one, Grant Prince.
Grant Prince with the goal there. Ties it again with 6:05 left in the second quarter. It's 6-6. Is somebody? All right, we apologize. We're back here on the GOKCD network. Oh, Vine makes a move inside. He's still looking for space. I have no idea how he held onto the ball there. Grissom, ooh. That was good defense from the Dragons there, and they will get the ball back. But either way, it's good to see some of our top players playing hard tonight. And oh, goodness, that was close there. They had a wide open player that could have easily gotten a shot off on that, on the edges of their defense again for the Bearcats. Have definitely needed to be cleaned up, but number three for South Oldham, definitely a quicker player, and there's a goal. Again, just on the edges of the Bearcats defense. It's been a tough night so far. Ian Gibbard with a hat trick. And that will give the Dragons their first lead of the game with 5:17 left in the second quarter. It is South Oldham 7, KCD 6. Bearcats are going to have to find a way to get back in this, not out of it at all by any of the equation, but South Oldham kind of flexing their muscle now, showing why they're one of the better teams right here right now. But I think many would agree that there's a lot of talent on this Bearcat team, and when it shows, they're easily one of the – oh, a great goal. There's Zach Vines, fourth of the game. The assist from Dermody. So, again, Dermody won the faceoff, made a run, and got it over to Vine, who took a great shot and able to score for the Bearcats. Deadly. There's no really other way of putting it. Really making a big offensive impact for the Bearcats so far. Oh, that was a fancy move there. It didn't end up working out for the Bearcats, but Dermody kind of flipped that ball behind him. And Tiva Ball with a great play to come away with the ball. He's going to run right into the middle of that defense for the Dragons. Goes right over to Ferguson. There's a whistle, and that's a timeout for KCD. That was a rough timeout. I'm not sure if Ferguson, among the other players, wanted that call. I think they had some decent space there and probably could have scored, but either way, it'll be Bearcat ball down in the zone for the Dragons. And with 4:50 left in this second quarter, your score, KCD 7, South Oldham 7. We'll be right back on the GOKCD Network. All right, we are back here. Bearcats with possession. Passes over, Vine passes over to Walters. And Vine looking over to Walters, who passes over to Hyken, who looks for some space inside, passes over to Jared Frank, back to Walters, and made three men miss. Oh, so close. That was a great, actually, he kind of got a little nick on the ball. There's Vine playing great defensive effort, and he is able to get the ball back. Oh, they just reversed the call down on the field. Originally, it was going to be a call for the ball for the Bearcats, but they just reversed the call. So, and there's a whistle back for start of play. So, I'm not exactly sure what happened. It looked pretty clear that it went out of that South Oldham player from that strong defensive effort. And there's a flag, and that'll most likely go against the Bearcats. Bearcats seem to be getting a little frustrated here, and let's see what the call is here. So that'll be a penalty against the Bearcats. That'll be a man down here, Ferguson out. Again, that's pretty frustrating there for the Bearcats, being in a great position there, and with the timeout that was called, and then not it was a strong offensive possession for them, but You hate to see a senior's defensive effort like that and not able to maintain possession. So either way, South Oldham back with the ball here. Tie game here with 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the second quarter. It's 7-all. If you wanted to rank tonight's matchup, I guess you could say KCD's probably in that 10 to 12 range. And South Oldham obviously in that top five range. So, and there's a good shot that went over just to the right of that top corner of the bar. And South Oldham maintains possession. Number 18 with a shot. And again, just under the legs of Gould. That's happened a couple times again tonight. Trevor Chapman with another goal, his second of the game. And with 306 left, it is South Oldham 8, KCD 7. And a couple of those goals have come right under. It's still been a great game for the Bearcats so far and still fighting hard. Again, this has just been a good game to watch so far. So let's hope for much of the same to continue. Dermody's still looking for it, but South Oldham comes away with it. Aston Robinson trying to catch up. And there's a missed pass, and Zach Ellis able to pick it up, looking for somebody out there. He still can't find someone there. It's the second time that he's almost given it away there, right next to the goal when trying to get it back to Gould. But and not really sure how to describe that hit. That was a strong effort from Connor Collis out there. One of our bigger, stronger players for sure. And definitely one of the most physical on defense. So that's one of his strong suits. Connor and his brother Bennett being on the boys' golf team, who had a great year. Of course, both of them are seniors, along with the majority of the golf team, so they'll see a bit of turnover for next year. Gould coming far out on the goal there, but there's a bounce pass to Grissom, back to Dermody, and to Walters, who scores! Goal! Dexter Walters. That was a great play set up by a missed pass from the Dragons. And senior Dexter Walters gets his first on the game. And the clear there by goalie Ben Gould. And that was just a great all-around effort from the Bearcats. And with 1:35 left in this half, it is tied up at 8. Let's see, there's a timeout. South Oldham. So with 1:35 left in the second quarter, it is KCD 8, South Oldham 8. We will be right back on the GOKCD Network. All right, and we are back here. Face off. There's a whistle that'll go turnover for the Bearcats. It'll be South Oldham ball with 1:31 left. Again, this has just been an absolutely fantastic game so far, and a beautiful day for lacrosse here on the campus of Kentucky Country Day. We hope that you will stay tuned in at halftime as we'll have your senior night ceremony here. Number three looking for some space. Back to 27. Who with a pass inside, and it's a good save by Gould there. Collis back to Gould, and Gould's going to come out a little bit. Again, this same type of play here is right where the Bearcats have been able to score on this long ball. Oh, good move by Walters. Back inside, he's got some space. Let's see it, pass inside. Oh, great play by the Bearcats. That was Walters to Grissom on the play, and that is a goal for your Bearcats. Again, that was set up by the clear, and that's the second time where they've sent a clear long, and Walter's able to get that made. It was probably mostly set up from that move he made inside, and Grissom has been able to kind of find his way around the goal back there and find some space and able to put another one away for the Bearcats. So with 27.3 left in the second quarter, it's KCD 9 and South Oldham 8. And we'll have your face off here. And it's squirted out there, but Ashton able to recover it. Let's see, yep, he found Dermody. He was wide open there. They're going to have some space again. And Vine with a shot that went just right and wide of it. So with 14.6 left in the second quarter, the Bearcats will have some time on this possession here. They're running, and that clock is running as well. And there's a shot by Vine. He scores. Vine with his fifth in this half. I'll tell you what, folks, that's been a heck of an effort from Zach Vine so far on this night. South Oldham has not been able to stop him for sure with five goals on senior night in the first half. It's been just a great overall effort from him and just the Bearcats team in general. It's been a great game so far, and the Bearcats are up by two with 5 seconds left here to go. And Dermody recovers it, three. Ooh, he got hit pretty hard there. He gets right back up. I think he's looking for a call, but that'll be a whistle to end this first half. And again, KCD 10, South Oldham 8. And that is your halftime. We hope you will stay tuned in for the senior night ceremony. And we will be right back right here on the GOKCD Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we'd like to honor our six lacrosse seniors. The first senior we would like to honor this afternoon is Connor Collis. Connor is the son of Bill and Debbie Collis. He's been a member of the KCD varsity lacrosse team for 2 years. In Connor's 4 years at KCD, he has been involved in many activities and other sports such as golf. He would like to be remembered as the founder of the famous Hit Fiesta with Colin Ferguson and his twin brother Bennett. Connor is looking forward to attending college next fall at the University of Miami. The next senior we would like to honor is Dexter Walters. Dexter is the son of Lisa Walters Purdue, has been a member of the KCD lacrosse team for 2 years. Dexter previously played lacrosse at North Oldham. His best memory was playing for the state championship last year on a brand new team. Dexter has also been involved in KCD football and track. He will attend the University of Colorado at Boulder, where he will study astronomy and astrophysics, and he hopes to eventually work in the field of theoretical cosmology. Our next senior, Jackson Alford. Jackson is a son of Heather and Hank Alford and has been a member of the KCD varsity lacrosse team for 4 years. In his 4 years on the team, Jackson has been on the district tournament team 2 times. His favorite lacrosse memories are beating Collegiate in the state semifinal and playing St. X for the state championship. Jackson is involved in student government. He has been a varsity player on KCD's football, soccer, basketball, and lacrosse teams for the past 4 years. Jackson will be attending Center College in the fall and will play soccer for the Colonels. Our next senior, Colin Ferguson. Colin is a son of Scott and Janie Ferguson and has been a member of the KCD varsity lacrosse team for 3 years. As a freshman, Colin was named offensive MVP for the lacrosse team. He has also received awards for KCD golf and basketball, including the board award for each sport. As a member of the basketball team, Colin is a member of KCD's 1,000 point club, and his AAU team finished on to the basketball team or play club lacrosse. Our next senior, Asa Hyken. Asa is the son of Jim and Susan Hyken and has been a member of the KCD varsity lacrosse team for 4 years. Asa's favorite KCD lacrosse memory is his everyday Chipotle discussions with Coach Walford. Asa has been involved in many activities during his KCD years, such as the varsity cross country team, and he is the proud president of the famous KCD Chess Club. Next fall, Asa will be attending Northwestern University, says his major is up in the air, but he's looking forward to whatever he runs into down the road. Our final senior tonight, Zach Vine. Mike and Susan Vine, and has been a member of the KCD lacrosse team for 4 years. Zach has been a 4-year varsity starter, 2-time All-District. He holds the school record for goals in a season, points in a game, and is KCD's all-time leader in goals scored. Zach's favorite KCD lacrosse memory is beating Collegiate to go to the first state title in the school's history. It is truly something that he will not forget. Zach will be attending college next fall, but has not decided between the University of Colorado at Boulder and the University of Texas at Austin. Zach Vine.
All right, welcome back, Bearcat fans. Second half face-off brought to you by Live Sportscaster. Visit their website and visit the About page for your next broadcast or event coverage needs. Hope you enjoyed our senior night ceremony, honoring our six wonderful seniors who've made a huge impact on this game already tonight and throughout their careers here at KCD. We thank them for all they've done. You're at the face-off here. We've got Dermody. He's done a great job facing off for the Bearcats tonight. I'd say he's probably won about 50% of the face-offs, but a great challenge from a highly ranked team in this state. And with that, we are underway here in the second half. And just like that, Dermody wins the face-off. Got taken around the neck. Yeah, there's a penalty there. Oh, and he almost scored, but there is a penalty on the play, so the Dragons will be a man down here, and we'll see if the Bearcats can capitalize and get them up by three goals, which will be huge in a game where Bearcats being up by two already, possibly being able to put it away early in this second half. And there's the whistle back for play. Vine over to Ferguson. Over to Wilder Bryce. Another one of our multi-sport athletes. Vine looking for some space with a shot, and he scores! Vine with his sixth goal on the night. And the Bearcats were able to capitalize on that penalty, and that's a great shot from senior Zach Vine with his sixth goal. And this has got to be one of his most memorable games in his career, and it's coming at a great time on senior night to be able to put the Bearcats up by three with 11:26 left to go in this third quarter. Your score, KCD 11, South Oldham 8. And back to your face-off here. It'll be Dermody. Whistle and gets it behind there, but South Oldham able to come away with the face-off there. Dermody's still working hard to try and get that ball back, but he's unable to. 18 coming around there, but there's a good hit to kind of force him out there. Oh, goodness. Again, right under the legs of Gould. And number three with his second goal of the game for South Oldham. Luke Niebergi with his second goal today. And with 11:08 left, the Dragons were able to cut that deficit back to two. And it's KCD 11, South Oldham 9 with 11:08 left in the third quarter. Again, right on that edges again. It's just been a tough area for the Bearcats to defend tonight. And South Oldham, a very athletic team, just as the Bearcats are on the offensive end. And there's Dermody. Looks like he'll win the face-up. Yep, he comes away with it. And a shot. Oh, just off target of the goal there. But Bearcats will maintain possession. Up by two here with 11 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Grissom over to Dermody, who back inside to Vine, and it just went left of the goal, but he gets it back to Ferguson, makes a man miss, and almost scores. Went off the shoe of the South Oldham goalie. Frank over to Dexter Walters, who will kind of calm down this attack here and try to get the Bearcats to find something here. Vine misses one inside. Oh, my goodness. I don't know how to describe this performance tonight, ladies and gentlemen, but Zach Vine is putting on a display here. Zach Vine with his seventh goal of this game. And it brings your score with 10:33 left in the third quarter. KCD 12, South Oldham 9. All right, and Dermody wins the faceoff over to Ferguson. On the initial attack, the Bearcats have done a really good job of being able to find space, and Vine has done a great job, obviously, scoring 7 of the Bearcats' 12 goals on this night. And, again, on senior night, so kind of takes the cake for the Bearcats. Back to Dermody, and I think they're switching some players back there, so they'll set their offense up, and of course, no rush here. There's a whistle. I think that I couldn't see the call there, but goes against the Bearcats. It'll be a turnover. South Oldham on the run, and number 26 for the Dragons, able to find some space. Get it on the offensive end for the Dragons. Oh, a miss there, and Lauder almost took that opportunity, but probably safe to get back and bats and South Oldham right back into this game. Oh, and there's a missed pass by South Oldham, and that'll be a turnover, and it'll go right back to the Bearcats. Wilder Bryce takes it outside. Let's see, there's the whistle for back into play, and he makes a man miss. And another slip and fall there from South Oldham, but Wilder Bryce out on the offensive end here. Again, Wilder Bryce scoring the big goal. Oh, there's a miss by Vine. Wilder Bryce, I was going to say, scored the maybe one of the biggest goals in KCD lacrosse history last year when he put the Bearcats up 5-3 in the state semifinal. There's a shot by Dermody, and he scores. Dermody's second of the game, and the combination of Vine and Dermody have accounted for 9 goals, 9 of the 13 goals from KCD here tonight, and can't ask for much better effort from the Bearcats right now, up 4 goals with 8:48 left in this third quarter. It is KCD 13, South Oldham 9. And another win, another face-off one for Dermody. He makes a shot, and it bounced just over the goal. Let's see who maintains possession. That'll be South Oldham ball. It was a pretty good effort there from the South Oldham goalie to try to get back there, and the ref just made a call that probably the ball went out and who got there first, but kind of went with the judgment call and gave it back to the Dragons, who are on the offensive end here. Number 3 trying to find some space. He passes behind. And he's got a little bit of space. Number 10 with a shot. Yep, that was an easy goal for the Dragons, who found some space finally inside. And
South Oldham goal by number 1, Grant Prince, his second of the game.
Grant Prince with his second goal of the game. Well, it's funny, you know, because last year the score actually was KCD 15 and South Oldham 10. So I guess we're getting similar to the type of score we had last year. Obviously, a completely different teams and different situation. But Dermody wins another faceoff. He's looking for some space. Oh, if Grissom was able to maintain that, that could have been a great opportunity there. And there's a call. It'll go against the Bearcats. It'll be South Oldham ball. He gets past Grissom. There's a pass over to number 15 for South Oldham, and they've got a little bit of space here. KCD trying to get back on defense, and they do. South Oldham will have to set it up. Number 15 makes a man miss. Oh, goodness. Let's see if there's a penalty there. No penalty. Play on, and it's probably a good no call there. Kind of fell with the ball, I guess you could say. But Bearcats much better defensively on this possession. But where they found space is when they make a few men miss. So Bearcats have got to keep their footing here and stay strong on the defensive end. Get physical like Tiva Ball is out there now. And that was actually a great, great defensive stand, I guess you could say, there for the Bearcats. And they've got to try and get this ball out. There's a shot and a great save by Gould there. Here we go. Gould makes that pass long, and Wilder comes up with it. He's got a little bit of space. Pass over to Grissom. Oh, goodness. That was close. I'm unsure how they didn't convert there, but I think the KCD coaches are yelling that was a shot. That should have been back to KCD. Kind of confusing how that wasn't back to KCD. I'm unsure if anybody else touched that, but coach is yelling for trying to get that call, but unable to. It'll be South Oldham ball here. 6:25 left in this third quarter here. KCD up 13-10. Again, senior Zach Vine with a huge night. 7 goals. And hopefully it'll be enough to get the Bearcats a win here tonight. Number 3 trying to find some space for the Dragons. I would say number 3 for the Dragons is definitely their quickest player. And matching him up with a guy like Ashton Robinson has been a good technique to kind of combat that. So there's almost another inside. And he's unable to handle it. Zach Ellis defending on the play there. Again, the Bearcats have been strong when they get them when they get the Dragons in a turnover spot. Oh, yep, he hit him right in the face there. That was a stick basically right in the chops there for the that'll go against the Bearcats. So there'll be a man down here, and we'll see if South Oldham can convert here and bring this to a 2-goal game with 5:21 left in this third quarter. Again, it's just been a great game to watch for either side. Very competitive, and overall just a great matchup. I think we're seeing some of the best lacrosse played by KCD so far, probably playing a bit inspired from that last loss, literally coming at the very last second of the game. So there'll be a conversation here. Don't think I've quite seen something like this before, this game is. I think we've just had Perrin ejected from this game here tonight. Hate to see that. But officials will convene here and right, and we are back here. Hate to see that one of our parents here getting thrown out, but that's sometimes that happens. So we're back to the game here, and there's a shot that went just to the right corner and over the bar, but South Oldham will maintain possession, and they'll roll the clock with 5 minutes left to go in this third quarter. And KCD up 3 goals, 13-10. South Oldham still putting in a good effort, trying to find some space and get back in this game. Ooh, there's a shot by number 10. I think that got blocked over the top. Oh, Dexter with a great play, kind of a Kind of how a soccer player kind of rebounds it to himself. And there's a shot. There's a shot inside. Yes, sir. There's another goal by Zach Vine. That is his 8th of the game, folks. And we're pulling out the nicknames tonight, folks. The franchise is the nickname for Zach Vine. And certainly if you score about 8 goals in one game, you'll get that nickname for you. And with 4:35 left in this game in the third quarter, it is KCD 14, South Oldham 10. It's just been a great... There's a win of the faceoff by Dermody, who passes it over to Dexter, who able kind of great catch of the ball there. And Grissom will look for some space back to the man of the night, Zach Vine. Well, and you just can't ask for a better senior night for Zach, because this has been a long career for him at KCD, here at KCD, and for him to score that many goals on one night in such a big game, it's been a great night for him so far. So hopefully the Bearcats can pull out this win here and continue to carry on that momentum throughout the season. So Ferguson, trying to make a man miss. Pass inside to Grissom. Easy goal for the Bearcats. That was a great effort from Ferguson. And again, Grissom with a hat trick, but Grissom has hung around that goal, and they have just not been able to defend him. And so it's been a great... it's just been a great play calling, I guess you could say, from there. And to see that he's just been wide open in front of that goal so many times. And that's where the Bearcats have been able to convert the most with Grissom on the night. It's just right inside there on the goal, or he could be possibly around the goal, and he can just get an easy pass off to someone else inside. And Bearcats have been able to get up big here. So Bearcats up 5 goals, KCD 15, South Oldham 10, with 3:30 left in this third quarter. And there's another almost. Oh, let's see. Yes, he'll come away with the faceoff win. Yep, he kind of rammed into him there, but that'll be the way for South Oldham. So South Oldham trying to find a way to get back in this game. Lots of momentum carrying on the way of KCD right now, but South Oldham not out of it yet. And there's another slip by South Oldham. Oh, that one just bounced right over the goal there. But I would say the Bearcats' strong suit is, and it's not where we've seen it in the past. They've obviously been working on their inside presence with their defense and have done a good job here tonight so far. Just the edges that we've seen the South Oldham team get some shots off, like right there. And so far, Bearcats have just had an offensive explosion on the night. I don't think we've seen quite this strong of an offensive performance all season long, and it's got the Bearcats up by 5 goals here. So again, we want to thank you for tuning in wherever you're watching, and we want to thank again the KCD Booster Club and the GOKCD team for helping this, making this possible tonight. So oh, and there's a shot that just bounces to the right of the post, and that'll go the way of KCD. I think Gould was able to get back there quick enough, and he got the ball back. Oh, is that going to be a turnover? Yes. So Gould got the ball hit basically backwards, and as a result, it bounced right out of off of him and gave the ball back to the Dragons. So they'll have an offensive possession here with under 2 minutes to go left in this third quarter. And I would say they've got to get something rolling here if they expect to get back in this game going into the fourth quarter. Yep, and that'll result in a turnover for the Dragons. That'll be KCD ball. So again, if you're just tuning in, we've seen a huge offensive performance tonight from the Bearcats. Senior Zach Vine with, and I'm not kidding, folks, 8 goals for the Bearcats on the night. And, there's Frankie misses it, but he's able to recover and bounce, and there's a flag. We'll see. That most likely will go against South Oldham. No call yet. Believe they'll call it after the lull in play. Vine looking for some space, a pass inside. I couldn't see where the ball ended up, but regardless, there's a penalty against the Dragons, and Bearcats will have the advantage here with 54.5 seconds left in this third quarter. KCD up 15-10 over South Oldham. So it'll be Jared Frank to put the ball in play for the Bearcats. Of course, Jared Frank, the quarterback of your KCD football team. Versatile player and obviously a versatile athlete playing multiple sports for KCD. There's Asa Hyken over to Frank, back to Grissom. And Grissom going to look for some space. Ferguson over to Hyken. Back to Frank, who loses the ball for a second, but able to recover. It looks like South Oldham is trying to hold that interior of their defense to make sure nothing happens inside. Oh, and there's a shot that probably not the best selection in the world, but hey, when you've got 8 goals on the night, not so bad to keep trying your luck. And Bearcats will, though, maintain possession. Ferguson. Back to Bryce, back to Ferguson with a shot. Oh, I went through the netting on that opposite side there. And it'll bounce out of play. He'll maintain possession with 6 seconds left. There's a shot by Hyken. No, couldn't get it off. And that'll be the end of your third quarter, folks. Bearcats with an offensive explosion in this game and added a couple goals to start this half off, and with to end your third quarter. Your score, KCD 15, South Oldham 10. We'll take a quick break and be right back on the GOKCD Network. All right, so this is the start of your fourth quarter, folks, and some news coming from the sideline there that Zach Vine with a there's a goal. And I was meant to tell you was that there, right before they scored that goal, that Zach Vine was found with an illegal stick. So that's a non-releasable penalty. So if the Dragons want to get back into it, now's the time to do it. And they start out this fourth quarter here strong with a goal. And with 11:44 left in this game, it is KCD 15, South Oldham 11. So hate to say that there would be anything against these this incredible performance on the night, because obviously Vine found a lot of space and scored a lot of goals just because of that spacing. But there's Dermody. He wins that faceoff. And I'm telling you that the winning that faceoff initially has been a huge help for the Bearcats, because, and especially right here, being down a man, they need to be able to. There's a flag against South Oldham. That's going to be a huge help. Oh, goodness, there was almost a shot inside. There's another flag. That's going to be an interesting call, because there were two different flags on that play, and they were two different areas. So I'm guessing that could potentially put them down two men. And with the Bearcats being down one guy and a non-releasable, that could even result in some more offense for the Bearcats. So we shall see here. Yep, they've got two men out here. Ferguson able to kind of get through the defense there and try to – almost got a shot off there, actually. So it would have been even more interesting to see them down two and them scoring a goal on top of that. So – kind of almost giving the – just when you thought that the Bearcats were at a disadvantage, the Ferguson senior able to kind of sustain some defensive punishment down there and got two penalties for the Bearcats, and we'll give them an offensive opportunity here, so we'll see what happens. I'm not sure how long Vine is out, but you would hope not too much longer. I mean, this has been a – great game so far, and you'd hate to see a senior have to sit out for the rest of the game. So, all right, there's the whistle back for play. And let's see, Wilder Bryce out there at wide, and Ferguson with the ball. Bearcats kind of playing a relaxed possession here, but then Dermody kind of faked that he was going to try and take a shot there that kind of scared back the defense a little bit. There's Dexter Walters kind of trying to threaten a little bit. Oh, and may have lost his focus there a little bit, but good play by Dermody to get back on the ball there and maintain possession for the Bearcats. And one of the defenders for South Oldham has just been released. So, oh, goodness, that was a great shot by Ferguson, but an even better save by the South Oldham there to keep them in this, and South Oldham with some space here. Number one kind of trying to stay back, and a shot that went just to the right of the post. And the Dragons have really found their shot from just underneath, low in on that goal. And I'd say it's resulted for almost at least half of their goals tonight. There's a shot, yep. And just as I spoke from where those shots have been coming from, South Oldham puts another one on the board and brings that lead to only three for KCD. Fourth by Niebergie there. So, again, as I spoke on earlier, he's probably their top athlete on this team. And it's becoming a bit of a worry for the Bearcats now. Vine's still out, and the Bearcats still a man down. So, Bearcats are going to have to try and find a way to just kind of muddle through this and try to win this game tonight. We've got a lot of time left here in this fourth quarter. With 10:19 left in the fourth quarter, it's KCD 15 and South Oldham 12. Oh, good effort there by Dermody. That was a heck of an effort to try and keep that ball for the Bearcats, and Hyken able to recover it. So he will kind of pull away back to Frank. And the Bearcats will try to probably run some clock here, but I see no reason as to why they wouldn't keep attacking as well. So, but we will see here. There is a good move by Grissom. Grissom with a little bit of space, but he will run out and back to Dexter Walters. Dexter Walters trying to kind of, and he's going to get doubled here. He's got to get that ball away to somebody. Oh, that was just out of the reach of South Oldham. Great job by Grissom to maintain possession, who gets it back to Frank. He's going to look for somebody. They're riding that out-of-bounds line hard out there. Oh, there's another flag, and I can't believe there wasn't a second flag on that play as he got, as Hyken got pushed in the back there pretty hard. But there's a call. Yep, so South Oldham would be down a man again. And, again, you've got to get any of those that you can for the Bearcats, as Bearcats are still out without their senior leader, Zach Vine, so the Bearcats still a man down. So I don't think any of us are too sure in the press box here of how long Vine's going to be out. So he's kind of pleading his case down there to try to get back in this game. But if you're just tuning in, there was an illegal stick against Zach Vine. So either way, Bearcats with possession here. Still up 3 goals with 9:10 left to go in this fourth quarter. And Dexter Walters. Back to, oh, nope. That was a stolen pass from South Oldham there. Oh, no. Number 27 for South Oldham has a lot of space on this play, but he's going to backtrack and try to probably set something up for the Dragons. I would say they have to get back in this quickly, but being down 3 goals with under 9 minutes left to go in this game, they've probably got to get something here on this possession to, oh, and a good save by Gould there. Gould's going to come out, and when Gould does this, when he's found people downfield tonight, it's paid off well, but he's going to pass off to Tiva Ball, who passes high to Robbins, who passes back to Ferguson. Ferguson makes a man miss. Ferguson inside to Dexter Walters, who scores. That was a great play, a great transition, and again, Walters with his second of the game, and Ferguson found a lot of space there, and that was, again, a great move to fake that initial shot, find that space over top, and then just get an easy shot off to score the goal for the Bearcats, which puts them up now 16-12 with 8:11 left in this fourth quarter. It is KCD. So Bearcats get that lead back up to 4, and a little more confidence going forward here. So back to our face-off here. Dermody trying to win it, and he does. He comes away with a face-off. So Zach Vine back in the game here. So that's big news for the Bearcats, is they took, I believe, 2 goals in that time. There's a call against the Bearcats. That'll be a turnover, and it'll be South Oldham ball. And goalie for South Oldham with a long pass downfield. I don't think number 18 for the Dragons was paying attention when that pass was thrown, but, Gould is out of the goal. He's got to just throw that downfield. Yep, and he does. Oh, that hit the South Oldham player right in the face mask, but Bryce working hard to get that ball back. He's still working hard down there on defense, sticking with it, but number 27 trying to make a round behind the goal, and he makes that ball come away from the Bearcats, and he recovers. So Wilder Bryce sticking with the play there. Oh, goodness, that was I wouldn't say it was the best move in the world, but the South Oldham has kind of fallen down a lot in the night. Oh, I think Heike probably could have taken that all the way around and shot it, but he pulled away on the play instead, and Bearcats will set something up. There's a long pass to Dexter Walters. Walters thought he was initially going to attack on the play, but chose to kind of pull out instead. And hiking back to Walters again. And and Grissom over to, I can't tell over there, Dermody, yep. And they're kind of playing along that back line. In the manual game, it was really interesting. With about a minute left to go, it was Hyken and Dermody on that back line, and they literally just passed back and forth for the entire minute, and Bearcats held off a huge rally from manual there. Oh, there's a shot by Wilder Bryce. Went just to the top, and South Oldham able to get the save there. Number six on the run for the Dragons. Bryce defending. Tiva ball out there defending for the Bearcats, and number 27 for the Dragons. And he makes that ball get out, and there's a whistle. And that'll be the way of the Bearcats, so they'll get the ball back here with 5:43, with in the fourth quarter. Score is KCD 16, South Oldham 12. Bearcats have built a good lead here and stuck with it even through a couple penalties. And, oh, I couldn't tell if that went in, did not. So Vine almost got his ninth on the night. But couldn't get away with it there. So, yep, that'll be back to the Bearcats after a long pass. Didn't work out for South Oldham, so going out of the way. There's Gould over to a high pass to Tiva Ball. There's another high pass that Grissom is able to maintain, and Vine over to Frank, and Frank with a shot but can't get it away, and Vine almost scores his ninth, but that goalie just had two big consecutive saves in a row and saves them from getting down five goals here late in this game when they are looking for just about anything. That referee reached for his flag but did not call it. We'll see here the Dragons looking for some space in this game. Makes a man miss. Frank working hard over there, but he's going to come away with a good defensive pressure there on the Dragons. And let's see, there's a, timeout, South Oldham. So with 4:13 left in this fourth quarter, your score, KCD 16, South Oldham 12. We'll be right back on the GOKCD Network. All right, welcome back, Bearcat fans. Oh, there's a quick restart there for South Oldham. It was a good save by Gould and holds that four-goal lead with 4 minutes left to go in this game. South Oldham has to get something going quick here. Ebergi trying to find some space for the Dragons. Oh, that's no penalty. Interesting. There's the flag. I thought for sure that would be a flag, and it is. So the Bearcats will be a man down with 3:51 left to go in this game. And if the Dragons want to get something going, now's the time to do it. All right, we are back here in action. Again, South Oldham's got to get something going quick. 3:40 left in this game. Bearcats up by 4 goals. KCD 16, South Oldham 12. There's a quick shot by number 18 for South Oldham, and a miss that went just over the left of the crossbar there. Or not crossbar, sorry, but the goal. So another good save by Gould. He is kind of anchored down late in this game, right when you need him. And there's a long pass to Grissom. A fake outside. He's going to keep running in, and he's going to stop. I thought he was going to throw it back to Frank there, but throws it back around to Dermody. Dermody's got some space around if he wants to take it, but he doesn't. He throws it back to... Oh, and Frank... Dermody. And Ferguson back to Walters, who will hold. And Bearcats just kind of passing it around now, trying to get some clock going here and come away with a big victory here today. Again, the story of the day so far has been, oh, there's a man miss. And back to, oh, Frank can't reach it. Probably a little too far in front of him there, but yep, there's a timeout by KCD.
Timeout
KCD with 2:26 left to go in this fourth quarter of play. Your score, KCD 16, South Oldham 12. And we will be right back. Welcome back, Bearcat fans. 2:14 left to go in this game. Niebergi trying to get anything going for South Oldham here. Oh, Ashton Robinson with a great defensive effort and working hard to get the ball back down there. There's a whistle, yep, and it'll go back to the Bearcats. You can give a huge credit there to Ashton Robinson for probably the best player for South Oldham down there, giving a great defensive effort to try and secure this victory for the Bearcats, and it looks like that will be the case here with under a minute, almost a minute 30 left to go in this game. And the Bearcats up 4 goals, 16 to 12. So not much longer in this game. Oh, and I think he kind of just fell on the play there. But number 4 for South Oldham trying to find some space. Back to number 1 who can't get a good shot off. And that will bounce away out of play. And that's got to be KCD ball, right? Yep. Yep, that'll be KCD ball. Gould with a good effort there to get back outside the goal there and be the first outside. And, Connor Collis with a good move. I believe that was Connor Collis. It could have been Zach Ellis as well. But a good team effort here today from the Bearcats. And a great individual effort as well from Zach Vine, who on senior night able to score 8 goals. I'm not sure on the records for that, but it's got to be up there when it comes to individual game-wise. And, regardless of, you obviously want to reach your highest potential when it comes to the season and postseason goals and things like that, but that's for an individual, from an individual perspective, that's a great accomplishment. So, and we've got about 30 seconds left to go here, and Hyken's going to take it out, and I'm guessing we're going to get the hold the ball call here, but I'm not really sure what just happened over on South Oldham sideline. I just saw somebody slide. Oh, I think we have a broken stick from South Oldham over there. So, there's no pole, but there's no end to that for South Oldham, so they're going to have to take a I'm not sure if that's an official's timeout or if that's coming from South Oldham, but either way, we're under 30 seconds here, so again, we want to thank you for tuning in tonight, and most likely your final score will be KCD 16 at South Oldham 12, barring any last-second goals or things here, so this has been a GoKCD Network broadcast. To purchase a copy, please email zach.lee@kcd.org. So that's zach.lee@kcd.org. It may not be reused unless given consent has been obtained. So, again, a little bit left to go here under 30 seconds, 27.8 to be exact. Left to go in this game. KCD up 4 goals, 16-12. And so there will be a change in the goal there. DT Trow for the Bearcats.
And a goalie for the Bearcats, D.T. Trowell, replacing Ben Gould.
So a great effort on the night by Ben Gould, and he has been replaced by our backup goalie, and I guess you could call him our hype guy as well, D.T. Trowell. Definitely always gets the guys excited on the sideline, and, you know, it's always good to have somebody that can kind of bring you back and make sure it's not always so serious all the time, which can often happen too much in high school sports in general. So it's always good to see that from a fun perspective of this game. So, and obviously just a great player in general. So, and South Oldham, we're going to try and get something here, but we are at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that's your ball game, folks. That shot will not count. And that's your ball game, folks. Your final score. All right, folks, that's your final score on this night. KCD comes away with a big victory over a top 5 team in this state. Your final score, KCD 16, South Oldham 12. Signing off, this has been Zachary Lee on the GoKCD Network. We thank you for tuning in, folks, and as always, Go Bearcats!